I see the question most of the time come up like this. Hey, I've got some mild steel tongs, and if mild steel tongs are good, then high carbon tongs must be great, and that's simply not the case. The question in a broader sense is this. Why don't we use higher carbon or tool steels for all the tools in the shop? It's literally called tool steel, right? Well, there's a really good answer in that. It falls in the function of what tongs are meant to do. Tongs are meant to grab onto something hot, and in that process, it transfers heat to the tongs, and then to keep it cool, you drop it in water. So the thing about mild steel is it has low carbon. The more carbon that you have in a material, the more it reacts to heat by hardening. It's, of course, a very simplistic explanation, but that's what it does. So the issue is, if you had like a really nice high carbon pair of tongs, when it absorbed that heat and you dropped it in the water, it's going to really lock down. It's, that crystalline structure is going to form, and it's going to cause it to crack. Now that's why rebar cracks, but I'll get to that in a minute. So by the very nature of what tongs are, you don't want them to have a whole bunch of carbon, because you're going to be heating them and cooling them in rapid session. So a little bit lower carbon gives them toughness, but it doesn't allow them to crack when that they are cooled. Now, a lot of tongs out there starting out are going to be mild steel, but some of the better tongs are alloys like 4140, which is technically a tool steel having about 40 points of carbon. However, this makes it a lot tougher, but it's still not enough carbon to really make it crack. When we have to have heavy-duty tongs, and we talk about a higher carbon steel for tongs, we're talking up to about 40 points of carbon. Now, this is the same about amount of carbon that 1045 has in that area, but it's that lower spectrum. It's not what we would consider a knife steel. It's not what we would consider any type of cutting steel. However, there's still enough carbon and alloying elements in there to make it tougher for the job that we're doing, but not so much that it's going to cause it to crack and fracture unduly. Now, rebar. Here's the reason that rebar tongs suck. Now, here's the thing. If you're using them and that's all you've got, fine. There's no problem with that. But if you use rebar tongs on a regular basis, you're going to figure out pretty quick they have a terrible habit of cracking in different places. The reason for that is that rebar is basically everything that they pour out of the dumpster made into steel form. That means that there are spots in that rebar that are much higher carbon than others. And again, it's like a whole fruitcake of crap. So what happens is, as soon as you get to that high carbon spot and you cool it, it's going to crack. Again, rebar tongs are not great. That's one of the reasons that myself and other professionals say, hey, don't waste your time. Get some mild steel, because you're going to spend all this time working on these tongs and they're just going to be the same garbage that you made them out of. If that's all you got, sure, no problem. But the moment you get the chance to go up to a better quality mild steel, please, by all means, do.